I need to tell you about something that happened. It's really terrible. My SwitchBot K10 Plus robot vacuum cleaner, known to her friends as Britney Clears, had an accident. We were casually experimenting with cleaning the carpet on the landing. I turned my back for 5 minutes and tick, tick, boom, she was in pieces on the floor in the hallway. Well, I can only assume that the drop detection sensors needed a clean, or she was being clumsy as she approached the top step. Whatever happened, it was all a bit of a blur, but I did hear the bump as she hit the first step, and then, oops, she did it again on every other step as she fell to her doom. I managed to put her back together, and at first I thought I'd been lucky, but now all she'll do is go round and around in circles. But don't cry, I have a plan to do something, to get her out of trouble, and to make her stronger again. So Brittany has gone in for exploratory surgery, and I've taken her apart, and it's actually not that difficult really. It's quite simple to take apart. You've got this top piece here, which has got the LiDAR scanner in it, and it just connected with one little connector there. I've got the dustbin just here, and there's a bumper that went on the front, and then the main body here, which was, oh, screws falling out, which is quite simple to remove all the components. Now, I traced the problem to one of the motors that's in the wheel. There's two wheels, one on either side, and this particular motor was the faulty one. And you can see, if I just hold it up, give it a bit of spin around. It's got a little circuit board on the back, one connector there, and a sort of cog on the motor itself. So I was struggling to find an exact match for the motor on places like AliExpress and eBay. I found very similar ones, but none with this special little circuit board attached at all, which I think is proprietary. So I contacted SwitchBot, and they have very kindly sent me two total complete wheel assemblies. So it should be a very straightforward swap out for one of these wheels. Taking this apart is really easy. You just need two Phillips or crosshead screwdrivers. So I've got one with quite a long reach on there and one that's more precision just here. So I'm going to start with the precision one because I'm going to take the bumper off along the front. Next, I'm going to remove the roller at the back, the sweeping brush, which just pops out because it's a replaceable consumable component. It goes over there. And now I have to open up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws that are all here. I'm actually cheating. I've only got 4 screws in at the moment because I opened it up just to prepare for this video. So let's open this up now. Okay, we turn it over carefully because I don't want to lose those screws. And we have to remove this cover very carefully. So when I lift it up, there is a cable connected inside. So I'm going to lift it here and I have to reach in and unplug it. And you can see it was just that one there. Put that to one side. Right then, what we're replacing is this wheel just here, which is, I think, the left one. Yep, that's the left one just there. Let's move it over here. You can see that's the left wheel. And it's held in by 3 screws, a spring, and a connector cable. So it's pretty simple to replace, actually. We start by taking the spring off. Put that there. Then I have to push it open like that, and just inside, I don't know if I'll be able to show this on camera, you should be able to see 3 screws just in here. A bit dark, but anyway, I'm gonna open it up anyway. It's a bit tricky to get the wheel out at this point because it's covered up by a switch that's in there, but you can just wiggle it around the switch and lift it out and then unplug the connector. And then we get the new wheel, plug the connector in and reverse the whole process. So put it back together in the reverse order that you took it apart in. Now, when you put this lid back on, you've got to make sure that this switch here matches up with the actual switch that's inside. So if you push them both to the left, which is off, and then you can lower it down and clip it into place. And then test that the switch works before you screw it all back together again. Okay, she's all back together again, so time to see if she actually works now. Fingers crossed.
Turned on.
She's turned on. Britney's back! The fact that this vacuum was so easy to repair is a real credit to SwitchBot's product designers. So 5 out of 5 for repairability on this product. Okay, so they don't actually sell the spare parts to customers, at least not at the moment, but hopefully they'll consider having a spare parts section on their online store going forward. This is a £400 robot vacuum cleaner that would have been total scrap due to my own carelessness. Replacing that one motor, which as you saw was pretty much plug and play, means that good old Britney has a new lease of life. What we need are more companies to step up and consider the repairability of their products, so that's both from a design perspective and the aftercare of making parts available. The more repairable products there are, the less waste there is to deal with. Okay, so perhaps the manufacturers might not sell quite so many brand new devices because people are repairing them, but maybe they'll end up with a boom in aftermarket parts that fills that gap. It's also possible that people might be more likely to buy one company's products over another simply because it's cheaper to own in the long run due to it being easier to repair. Anyway, I'll put a link in the description to my original review video of the SwitchBot K10 Plus and a link to where you can buy it too in case you're interested. These amazing people here are my channel members, so thank you very much to you guys for supporting my channel. If you would like to become a channel member too and get early access to my videos, then please click on the join button under the video for more information. Please give the video a like and subscribe to my channel to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.